Hey everyone, in this video, I'm going to introduce you to function handles. First, I'll explain what a function handle is. Then we'll create a user-defined function and assign a function handle to that function. Finally, I'll show you how to pass a function handle as an input argument to other functions called function functions. Let's get started. Before we head over to MATLAB, let's take a look at the definition of a function handle. A function handle is a data type that stores an association to a function. You can create function handles to name user-defined functions and anonymous functions. To create a function handle, precede the function name with an at sign. For example, we could assign the function handle fun to a user-defined function named myFunction by preceding the function name with the at sign. Let's take a look at our first example. For this example, we're going to create a user-defined function to compute y, which is the square of the elements of x. This function has one input argument, x, as well as one output argument, y, and one calculation, where y is assigned the value of the elements of x squared. After we create the function, we're going to create a handle to the function and name the handle sqr, which is an abbreviated version of the full function name. Let's head over to MATLAB. Now that we're in MATLAB, our first step is to open a new function file. On the Home tab, click the plus sign for new and then function, which opens a template. The first line is the function definition line, which begins with the keyword function. Next, we have a comma-separated list of the output arguments of the function enclosed in square brackets. Our function has one output argument, y. On the right-hand side, we have a comma-separated list of the input arguments to the function enclosed in parentheses. Our function has one input argument, x. The last item on this line is the name of the function. We're going to name this function compute square. Below this line, we have a comment section. The first comment line begins with the name of the function, which is compute square. Then we provide a summary of the function. This function computes the square of the elements of x. After this comment line, we have the calculation section where the output argument is computed based on the value of the input argument. We have one calculation for the output argument y. Y is assigned the value of the square of the elements of x. And notice I'm using the period character to indicate this is an element by element operation. And that way, if a user inputs an array of x's, we'll still be able to use the function. I'm going to add a semicolon at the end of this line to suppress the output to the command window when the function is called. Our function file ends with the keyword end, and that's it. Now we're ready to save our function. To save the function, go to the Editor tab, click Save. The function name will auto-populate as the file name. Click Save again. Now we're ready to assign a function handle to our user-defined function. To assign a handle to the function, go to the command window and type in the name of the function handle, in this case, sqr. We're going to assign the function handle to our user-defined function. First, we'll precede the function name with the at sign. Now we type in the name of our user-defined function, and that's it. I'm going to add a semicolon to suppress the output to the command window. But when I click Enter here, if we look in the base workspace on the right-hand side, we can see our function handle and then the name of the user-defined function it's assigned to. Now we can call the function using the function handle instead of the function name. For example, we could assign the output of the function to the variable y. So y is assigned the value of. Now we're going to call the function by typing in the function handle, and we'll provide a value for the input argument x. So for example, we'll provide a value of 2 for the input argument. I'm going to add a semicolon to suppress the output to the command window. But when I click enter, if we look in the base workspace on the right-hand side, we have the variable y has been assigned the value of 4, which is the output argument of the function, but we used the function handle instead of the function name in the call. Now that might seem like this doesn't really save a bunch of time, but one of the benefits of using function handles is you can pass a function handle as an input argument to other functions. So let's take a look at a second example. As I just mentioned, a common use of function handles is to pass one function to another function. This process is called function functions. For example, you can pass a function to MATLAB's integration function integral. So let's take a look at an example. Let's say we want to integrate x squared from x is equal to 0 to 2. If we were to solve this problem by hand, we would first recognize the antiderivative of x squared is x cubed over 3. Then we would evaluate the antiderivative at the limits and subtract to obtain an answer. But let's say we wanted to evaluate this integral in MATLAB. The integral function in MATLAB can be used to numerically evaluate an integral. We can see the syntax of the function below, where the integral function has three input arguments. The first input argument is the integrand, which is specified as a function handle. The second input argument is the lower limit, and the third input argument is the upper limit. So let's head back over to MATLAB and pass our function handle to the integral function to numerically evaluate an integral. Now that we're back in MATLAB, we're going to go to the command window and call the integral function. We'll type in the name of the function, which is integral, and then an open parentheses. Now we're going to provide three input arguments. The first input argument is the function handle, which is SQR. The second input argument is the lower limit, which is 0. And the third input argument is the upper limit, which is 2. Now I'm going to close the parentheses and click enter. And here we see the result of MATLAB's numerical integration of our integral as passed to the function using the function handle. All right, that's it. I hope this video provided you with a good introduction to how to create a function handle and pass a function handle to another function. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video and would like to see more, subscribe below. If you would like to support the channel, consider becoming a member or check out some of the Spartan Professor merchandise available in my shop. You can find me online and on social media at David Calamus and Spartan Professor.